Good day, class. So for today, we're going to be tackling on how to determine the response of first order systems in series. Now, this particular module is only limited to liquid level systems and mixing systems wherein we are not only considering the response of just a single system, but rather of several systems. And the arrangement here can either be coming in two different fashions, which will be discussed in a little while. So now we will be starting off with the liquid level system that is non-interacting. So the second type is, shall we say, interacting, the opposite of this one. So when we speak of a non-interacting system, now specifically the liquid level system, the outflow from the previous tank is being discharged directly into the atmosphere before it's going to be introduced into the next tank. Now the flow here coming from the first tank is through the linear resistance one, which is labeled as R1, and it is dependent on the level of the liquid in the particular tank wherein it came from. So R1 is the linear resistance where the outflow from the first tank is passing through or flowing through, and it depends on the level of that particular tank. Now, variation in the level of the succeeding tank does not affect whatsoever the transient response of the previous tank. So meaning, whatever is the degree of variation of the level in the next tank is not dependent on the transient response of the previous tank. And this is what it meant by the third thought in this slide. Now, the representation of a non-interacting tank in series, specifically two tanks in series, are the ones you have seen here. So you have Q as the volumetric flow rate of the liquid being introduced into the first tank. H1 is the level of the liquid in the first tank. Q sub 1 of T is the volumetric flow of the fluid coming from the first tank flowing through linear resistance 1. Now the way we label tank 2 is the same as the way we label tank 1. So if you notice here, the volumetric flow rate coming from tank 1 is being discharge in the atmosphere, and then it's introduced onto the next tank, which is in this case is just the second tank. Now, determining the overall transfer function of this system will require us to do material balance for both tanks, and then making use of the individual material balances, we now have to incorporate the principle of Laplace transform in determining the individual Laplace transforms of each tank. Then this final Laplace transform of the system is coming from, or is just a product of, the two individual transfer functions of the tanks. So these are the two transfer functions of the tanks that you have shown, or that was shown to you in the previous slide. So what we are doing here in determining the overall transfer function of the two tanks in series is just a manner of multiplication of their individual transfer functions. Now, if we intend, just like for a single tank, if we intend to change the level of tank 2 to the outflow through tank 2, and still depending on the changes in the volumetric flow rate of tank 1, then this particular system transfer function is simplified in this form. This is in the case when we have identical tanks. Identical meaning their tau primes are equal, their linear resistances are equal, and their cross-sectional areas are equal. If the two tanks are not identical, then all you have to do is just change H2 here in terms of Q2. The same linear relationship governs Q2 in terms of H2. Just like as if you're considering a single tank in the case of tank 2. That way, you can change the H2 here to Q sub 2. That is in coming up with the simplified transfer function relating the volumetric outflow from the last tank to the changes in the volumetric inflow to the first tank for, again, identical systems. So these two you can memorize. When you solve problems, you need not go back to that derivation. Now, I hold you responsible for the manner of deriving this overall transfer function for our two tank system in series. Now, if we have several tanks, like n-tanks, non-interacting n-tanks in series, the manner of determining the overall transfer function of the system is just like as if you're multiplying all the transfer functions of each of your tanks in series. So this symbol is to be interpreted as a multiplication of the transfer functions of each of your tank, comparable to the summative symbol that you have when you are adding values for a series of terms. This one we're not adding, but rather we are multiplying. You are multiplying the individual transfer functions of your tanks in series. So this is for our non-interacting first order systems in series. Now, if we're going to compare the plot of the response of each of your tanks in series, whether you have only a single tank, you have two tanks, you have three tanks, and four tanks here, you could see that there is somewhat a change in the shape of the response for a step change in the input. If you notice, our response becomes more and more sluggish, meaning it's lower. The effect of the change in the flow rate to the first tank is slowly felt if we have more tanks in our series. Or shall I say, the shape of the response curve is like of an S. Now, of the four, if you're going to compare, the effect of the change in the input is felt rapidly when you have only a single tank. That's very self-explanatory. The system feels right away or is affected right away by the changes in the input because you only have a single system. In the case of the two-tank system, the effect in the level in the second tank will take some time if compared to you are only having a single tank. So much more so if you're going to add more tanks in your system. The level change in the last tank will be felt by the system, that is still the last tank, a little bit slower compared to, or a lot slower compared to the response if you only have a single tank. The term that is used here is sluggish. We add more tanks in our system, in the case here of two tanks, three tanks, and four tanks, the more sluggish is our response. The more S-type is the response curve. That is in the case of non-interacting first-order systems in series. Now, we have another manner of contacting, or rather connecting. The appropriate word is connecting our tanks. So, another way is the interacting system. In this case, the flow through a resistance in between tanks is dependent on the difference between the level of the first tank and the level of the second tank. That is if we have only a two-tank system. So if we have several tanks in our system, the flow rate in between tanks will be dependent on the head, or that's the level of the liquid of the tanks in which it is in between of. So if you're talking about flow rate from tank 3 to tank 4, then that flow rate will be dependent on level 3 and level 4. So we're taking the difference of the levels of the liquid in level 3 and level 4. So if we have only a two-tank system arranged in interacting fashion, flow through our linear resistance 1 depends on both levels H1 and H2. Now, the variation in the level of the succeeding tank this time affects the transient response of the previous tank. Ironic as it may seem, but this time the level of the succeeding tank is already a factor or a determining factor in the flow through the linear resistance. And as such, the variation in the level of that particular tank, and that is the succeeding tank, will be affecting the transient response of the previous tank. Since both levels are actually factors to consider regarding the flow through the resistance between the two tanks that are being studied or connected. Now, as you can see here, the flow rate from tank 1 is not discharged into the atmosphere, but rather it's discharged at the bottom part of the tank. introduced also on the second tank, but also on the bottom part. So as such, we say that Q sub 1, the level from the volumetric flow rate or flow rate from tank 1 is dependent on both levels, H1 and H2. It's because the head here of tank 2 will have a certain pressure applied to the fluid that is supposed to be introduced on its bottom. So the lower the level, the ease for this particular flow rate to be introduced on the second tank. And that's the easier way. But the higher the H2 is, the more difficult it is for Q1 to enter the bottom of the second tank. This has something to do with the pressure that the level or the fluid in your second tank is exerting to the volumetric flow rate from tank 1. So Q1 in here in interacting tanks will not be a case of H1 over R1. Also will not be a case of H2 over R2. But rather Q1 is equal to H1 minus H2 over R1. So the difference between the levels of the two tanks in which it is in between with divided by the linear resistance in which it is flowing through. Okay, Q1 is equal to H1 minus H2 over R1. So it's not the same as if when you are only having a single tank, wherein Q1 is just H1 over R1, or even if we have a non-interacting tanks, because your Q1 is still H1 over R1 in that sense. So only in interacting fashion is Q1 dependent on both levels, H1 and H2. Now, our transfer function for interacting systems, let's say we'll limit it only to two tanks arranged in interacting fashion, and that's level liquid still, this will be its transfer function. So it's second order, tau 1 tau 2 S squared plus tau 1 plus tau 2 A1 R sub 2 S plus 1. So the denominator this time is already complicated. Why? Because our Q1 is equal to H1 minus H2 over R1 in this case. You are still going to do material balance individually between tanks 1 and tanks 2, or for each of tanks 1 and tanks 2, but the manner of determining this is now dependent on the new linear relationship between the two levels, H1 and H2 and Q sub 1. Again, the same principle will be applied if you change your level 2 here to volumetric flow rate through that particular linear resistance, R2, so Q2. And this particular transfer function class, again, is only applicable if your tanks are identical. A1 and A2 are equal and linear resistances being equal also. Then from a complicated transfer function, we have this less complicated transfer function, but this one, take note, is Q sub 2 related to changes in Q. This one is H sub 2 related to changes in Q. If you're going to compare the response to a step change in the input for an interacting tank and a non-interacting tank, it would be in this manner. So non-interacting tanks, two tanks, you have this. Interacting, you have this. So we could see in our graph for the two responses that your interacting tanks are even more sluggish in terms of response compared to non-interacting tanks. It's even more sluggish to non-interacting tanks. So meaning, the changes or the last system in your tanks in series will feel the effect of the change in the volumetric inflow to the last tank slower than if it is non-interacting. So slower the manner of the system responding to the response if it's interacting is slower in this case. Slower, meaning hinay siya. If it's non-interacting, then it's fast, because if you look at the curves, this one is less s than this one. So the terms again that we're using here is sluggish. If you have an interacting system, it's sluggish compared to a non-interacting systems in terms of the response. So you are to review on this, and you use this as the basis in processing again the next group assignment, the group assignment number 2, and that would be your problem set number 2. Those who will not be picked in our discussion on Wednesday will automatically be the ones that will be reporting the solution of the 3 problems for the given problem set for this topic. I have already posted the problem set, so you may prepare ahead for their solution. Thank you for listening, class.